Travis Schreier and Charlie Potter from just outside Bryant-Denny Stadium on the University of Alabama campus, where Charlie, Alabama going through its first scrimmage of the 2015 preseason. We were just inside for the abbreviated viewing period. Saw a few things of note, specifically at the running back position, I guess.
Yeah, it looked like Kenyon Drake wasn't doing much of anything. Yeah, he was just kind of standing there. You couldn't notice any limp or anything like that. So that tells me he's not going to do much today, which opens up, you know, an area for Damian Harris to get a lot of carries, because right as we were walking on the field, it appeared he was working with the first team with Derrick Henry. So that's good news from a young standpoint. It didn't look like it was anything too serious with Kenyon. We don't really know the extent of that injury as of yet. I'm sure Saban will address that afterward. But, yeah, he and Bo Scarborough didn't look like they were going to be doing much today.
Yeah, and you're right. They probably wanted to get Damian Harris a lot of work, and Ronnie Clark, maybe even for that matter. Derek Gore, the walk-on that you've heard some things about. So it should be a very busy afternoon for young Harris, I would think, at this point, when you look at the potential for breakdown of carries. As far as the quarterback rotation, it looked like, again, you said as we were walking out, no real changes there from what we saw. Who knows what's going to happen once they get going?
Yeah, I mean, Jacob Coker was again with the first team, and then it kind of looked like it went down by grades almost. You know, I saw Alec Morris with kind of what looked like the second team, and then Cornwell was with the third team, and then they kind of mixed it up a little bit. But for the most part, I didn't see anybody else with the ones outside of Jacob Coker. And today, they'll be the testing ground. We'll see, you know, after today, I think they're going to try to divvy up the reps at the quarterback position, and I think that, you know, they're going to give a lot to Jacob Coker today. We'll see how he handles it.
Looks like Richard Mullaney might be a big day for him too. Chris Black once again limited, and again from the little we could tell, and we saw this last Sunday in the open practice, a guy that when you talk about the three wide receiver set specifically could be a nice opportunity for him.
Yeah, I mean, as we were walking on the field again, he was out there with Robert Foster and Ardaeus Stewart, and that's really no surprise from what we've seen. Mm-hmm. He seems like a sure-handed receiver that can, you know, slip in the slot and be a serviceable receiver. He and Parker Brano have been the guys working there, but Mullaney seems to have the edge in that regard.
Dylan Lee, again, with the inside linebackers, looked like he was paired up with Reggie Ragland in some of the pre-scrimmage work. The expectation still being that Reuben Foster, I'm sure, is going to get a lot of work at that spot. But interesting to note nonetheless. Really couldn't tell a whole lot about the secondary, but the guess is that, you know, like the other spots, probably a lot of what we've seen so far. Anything on Lesser Cotton? You got any updates for us?
I didn't see him out there. I could have sworn I saw him get off the bus, but I didn't see him out on the field. So he probably won't get any work today, not being out on the field.
Lot to decipher from Nick Saban's post-scrimmage press conference, not just about what goes on in there today, but some injuries that, you know, it'll be interesting to get updated on. So that's just about going to do it, I would say, from Bryant-Denny Stadium for Charlie Potter. I'm Travis Schreier reminding you to keep it right here for all your post-scrimmage coverage from Bryant-Denny Stadium.